Staff. Okay. Topic is Venezuela. Actually, topic is continued imperialism and continued land grab. Continued, when I say land, we also mean the minerals and all the resources of a country. The continued subjugation of people, not respecting the wishes of a nation, if there is such a thing. You know, there's a thing. We're sitting in a Sussex right now, and Sussex actually dedicated. I shouldn't say it this way, but we have a large influence of Neely Fuller Jr. in this situation, in this Sussex. And one of the things that Neely Fuller always talks about is that in a system of racist white supremacy, they have no borders. The people who run the system, or who gain from the system of Anglo-racist white supremacy, there is no borders for them. They go where they want. They do whatever they want. That's why they call it white supremacy or system of supremacy. Now, that system of supremacy currently was invented by whatever, or developed by Anglos, if you will. But anybody can do it. You can put anybody in the thing. Like before, what if it's Irish people didn't used to be Anglos? Then all of a sudden they became Anglos. You know, you see what I'm saying? You know, the Italians used to be Anglos, then became Anglos when they became Americanized. You know what I mean? Or taking over the country. Anyway, so what I'm talking about right now is that these folks, they can do anything. And in a certain sense, you know, because they go in their little circle of their little cabal, you know, cabal that includes at this particular point, the EU or some foxes, people in the EU, you know, you got the new wacko, not ration. Don't call names like that. The new person in charge of Brazil. You know, there's a bunch of other people that signed it on. Costa Rica? Come on, Costa Rica is just a vassal. They have more Americans in Costa Rica than that, anyway. But the point is, they got people to sign on to this, and then they say, no, well, you who was elected the president of this country, you're no longer the president, because this president who ran against you, he's now the president. How do you? Well, they do it, okay? But here's my concern. These things, they've been trying to deal with Venezuela ever since Venezuela said, did the whole oil thing and didn't do with OPEC thing, whatever it is. And then since then, you know, since Chavez and now Maduro, you know, they've been going after that country trying to get those resources. But here's the thing, that since this thing has been going on for 10, whatever, more years, 20 years, I don't know, they've been going on for a long time, they've put plans in place all the time. They're always waiting for a little in, and then they'll do something. That's what they did in Honduras. You know what I mean? They wait for something to happen, and they do a little in, and they put their person there. The military surrounds it. The whole thing, they get whatever it is. It's not going to happen that way in Venezuela, I can tell you that, because it's more like Venezuela landscape is more like, it's not even like Syria. It's more like, I don't know, Vietnam. You know, it's a lot of jungle. Anyway, but that's not what they're concerned with. They just want to control the oil so they can take that out and do whatever they want and sell it on. Talk about selling it. Sorry. Forget that. Let's go to Kamala Harris. Kamala Harris, who did not prosecute this guy Steve Mnuchin, who was a banker, and they ripped off all these predatory loans and all this, you know, this foreclosures of black people. And she did not prosecute, even though her office said to prosecute him. Well, he ended up not being prosecuted. Then he ends up being in the Trump administration. What is he? The Secretary of Treasury, and that Secretary of Treasury now says they've taken the gold that was in the states, whatever it is, or whatever the reserves are, and they take it. Well, you no longer have access to your money. You know, and England's going on because I say England, London is the financial capital of the world, whatever it is. They say it's New York, but still, London is all that wheeling dealing. Anyway, they said, now you no longer have this money. This money belongs to this other guy. We're giving it to this guy, which means we give it to ourselves. How do you? Well, they do it. They did it. But my point is, what is the end game? I always think about this. A long time ago, I think, these people go to Mars. What does that mean? All the rich people are going to go to Mars. They'll grow their food there, whatever have you. Or they grow food in Mars and bring it back here and charge us a lot or whatever. Somehow they want to be another planet so that they can control it, really control it, and use the people in the States or people on Earth as matrix kind of people, just drawing resources from them and their lands. But I was thinking, even if this doesn't work for them, it does work for them, because what they're trying to do is say, even if you have this vast country, I'll control this part right here. right? Therefore, I have your resources. Your country means nothing. It's like DRC, you know? It's like a lot of African countries. They're controlling the coltan, when as a country is going, it's poor. You know what I mean? Same thing in Nigeria. They control the oil, but the country is poor. Because the people in charge allow these people to continue to do what they do, not knowing that all they're trying to do is get little portions all over the planet to control, and then, you know, you'll be controlling nothing. You'll be controlling the wheat fields while they control all the diamonds and the minerals and the oil and all the rest of that stuff. Forgive me, I'm in Lembete. You hear neighbors talking loud or whatever happened. I don't know why they're doing that, but they do that. So forgive the interruption. So what I'm trying to say, I think the final end game is they don't want to control countries necessarily. They want to control portions of countries, even the United States. Remember, it's the United States of America. It's different states. So even if they get if you get the national government to go away, no more national government, no more president, no more rest of that stuff, right? And then the states, each state, right, with their governors, they become president of those states. So basically, you'll have 50, you know, 50 ruling entities, whatever, unless some regions want to come together. That's the kind of thing that they want, you see? And that's why they wanted putting all these people in power, all these people in charge of places like then the EP, you know, Environmental Protection Agency. They're putting people, Trump and his crew is putting people in place that dismantles that so they can get their little regional things. And then, oh, I control Mar-a-Lago, I control this. It happens already. Think about it. New York State is a beautiful state. New York is, everybody talk about California, whatever. New York is beautiful, but a lot of the beautiful parts you can't see because the Rockefellers actually own large swaths of land. Like Ted Turner owns all, like a lot of Montana or whatever it is. That's the point. That's the end game, I think, is they want to get rid of control little nation state governments or whatever have you, but they want little strategic parts, you know, this area, that area, they'll control so they can do their bidding and continue their wealth sucking, you know what I mean? So I just had to get that off because this whole Venezuela thing is troubling, and it's troubling not just because, the European, rather, the African Union is not going for it, you know, China is not going for it, you know, Russia's not going for it. And I think that Russia even is taking some, what is it? I think that Venezuela has given Russia oil or gold or something like that to take away. I think it's gold. Anyway, that's it for me here in the Susset. Me, T, from the Patterson State in the Trench of Tibet, letting you know what I only suspect.